All right, Lauren, keep going. Continue.
And I thought that I was strong.
There you go.
There it is. It's hard to believe. 25 years since, you know what, I heard it on satellite radio yesterday.
Oh.
Do you think, because I think there are a few iconic songs like Stay, Lisa Loeb is here, of course. Do you think a song like that is playing somewhere all the time?
I hope so. I hope so. You know, it means so much to me that people still really connect to the song.
Right.
And I play a lot of concerts all over the place, and people always are telling me about, like you, telling me about how you know every word to every, you know, every lyric.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of lyrics in that song.
There are.
I've seen people reenact the entire one take video.
We used to do that.
And everything. And but it's so great to have that nostalgic piece. But also I see people in the audience still connecting with it. And I also connect with it still today. So it's really cool to have that kind of ongoing feeling about the song Stay.
First number one song ever by a quote-unquote unsigned artist. How quickly did you get signed after that song?
I actually got signed while the song was number one on the charts. I had a bunch of different record companies courting me, and people had been interested, but that song getting on the radio, that was the thing that just, all the A&R people, their bosses were now calling me on the phone, you know, what's going on? When are we gonna sign you? Yeah. So there was a whole bidding war, and literally August, 25 years ago, I signed my first major label record deal.
Wow.
That's a big undertaking, the one-take video.
It was unbelievable doing a one-take video. Yeah. You know, Ethan Hawke, who was an actor from the movie Reality Bites, where the song was on the soundtrack, Ethan had a great idea of doing a one-take video. And he actually showed me in his small apartment in New York. We were neighbors. He showed me, like, this is how we'll do it. And it was, like, choreographed, not, like, dancing, but just, like, you'll stand there, and then the cat will come in here, and I'll come around here with the camera. And he had it all worked out. And the record company decided to go ahead and let him make a video, RCA Records did, because it was Ethan Hawke. But it was actually the idea of the video being a one-take that was so different at the time, because MTV was made up of all these really brightly colored, you know, highly edited, great videos. And so this was a big contrast and a great way to tell the story.
Oh, an absolutely fantastic way to tell the story. We've put together a compilation because there's other in your discography. Right?
Yes, my discography.
We've truncated your discography.
Okay.
Into this highlight reel.
Oh, let me see.
Ooh, child, things are gonna get easier. Ooh, child, things will get brighter. The sun will come out tomorrow. So you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Sweet dreams that leave all worries behind you. But in your dreams, whatever they be, dream a little dream of me.
All right, this is maybe almost an athletic question. The voice is as good now as it was then.
Yes.
What has one done to maintain that?
One drinks a lot of water, gets sleep, works with a vocal coach sometimes. And, you know, I have great musicians and I have great people that I work in the studio with, so it always sounds very nice. And that, it's funny, that's actually a compilation from my latest record called Lullaby Girl. I have another record coming out in October, but that's called Lullaby Girl. And we did all these different covers with a great band, including Larry Golding's. And I'm wearing the same dress, so well, you know, just letting
perfect.
You know.
There you go, perfect. Off to Japan in a little bit, but before that, a warm-up performance we're
yes.
describing.
You know, I haven't done a grown-up show in Los Angeles in a while. I usually do kids' shows because I have a lot of kids' music out as well. And I'm going to Japan on Saturday to do a tour in Japan. So to warm up for that, I'm working with my musician that I'm doing my show with, and we're going to perform at Dynasty Typewriter, which is this cool old theater near MacArthur Park, but on this side of, I'm saying this side, I don't know where you live, of downtown. But it's this really great theater. So we're doing this nice, intimate show in this great little theater Thursday night, tomorrow night.
Oh, okay.
So,
there'll be songs. I'll play Stay. I'll play a lot of songs from my catalog, songs you might know from the radio of mine, as well as songs from my new album that'll be out in October that is not even out yet. Singles will be dropping soon. That's what they say now.
And then
singles dropping.
As we're having the conversation and people are admiring your eyewear, is this your own Lisa Loeb eyewear?
It is. It's a frame called Cake and Pie. It's named after one of my albums, and I have a whole eyewear line called Lisa Loeb Eyewear. And you can get it at mom and pop ophthalmologist and optician's office stores, as well as Costco. And there's also glasses for young girls and petite women there as well.
See, Lauren,
I love anything for petite women. Yeah. We're overlooked.
I know, we are. You'd be cute in those glasses.
I was going to say, you only see what you want to.
Oh, yeah.
Would that work?
It will work.
God.
It will work.
Okay.
Oh, this is why Mark does not work in the eyewear business. Don't miss Lisa Loeb performing live Dynasty Typewriter in the Hayworth Theater tomorrow night, 8 p.m. For tickets, Dynasty Typewriter.com. Lisa, really nice to see you. Congratulations.
It's always great to see you. Thank you.
Thank you.